Hello, everybody. I'm so excited for you to join us on our stream today. You could have went to any live stream today, but you decided to come to Buttonwood UMC's live stream, and we're glad about it. In the time that we're living in on today, listen, we need a savior, and that answer is Jesus Christ. We have a special broadcast that's lined up for you on this week, where we have some just online, just only for those that are watching online can see this on today. So we have a special broadcast that's going to be lined up for you today. We want you to go grab some notes, grab your friend, grab your Bible, let them know that Buttonwood UMC stream is online right now. Our choir is going to come before us. I'm going to come back for a word. We're right in the middle of our first series here at Buttonwood, which is called Road Trip. And we're taking a road trip through the scriptures. So listen, we'll be right back in a few moments.
Our call to worship. In the midst of our troubles, we cry aloud to God. God always hears our cries and responds to our needs. God brings us up out of our trouble and sets us in a safe place. God comforts and restores our souls. The Lord has turned our mourning into dancing. We have been clothed with joy and hope. Amen. every hour, most gracious Lord. No tender voice like thine can peace afford. We need thee, oh, we need thee. Every hour we need thee. Oh, bless us now, our Savior. We come to thee. Lord, we come this morning thanking you for another day. We thank you for your many blessings. We pray this morning that you may bless and fill our families with love, peace, and prosperity. We pray for joy, abundance, and strength. We pray for great health and continued healing. We pray for our loved ones. We pray for those that don't know you for themselves. We pray for your kindness and your mercy. We pray for your guidance and protection. We pray, Lord, that we love our neighbors as you have loved us. Let us be your light in the world. Bless us now, our Savior, as we come to thee, always remembering that the honor, glory, and the praise is due to you. In your precious name we pray. Amen.
Song says, Papa Jesus, the light of the world. Everybody that like old school church,
walk in the light,
beautiful
light.
Come on, stand with us and sing it. Come well.
Come where the true trust,
hush,
of mercy shine bright. Shine all around us by day and by night.
Can we do it like the old church? One big mass congregation. Let's go. Everyone stand on your feet and sing it. Lift it up all over down your road. Walk!
Scripture reading this morning is coming from the 10th chapter of Luke, verses 25 through 37, their parable of the Good Samaritan. On one occasion, an expert in the law stood up to test Jesus. Teacher, he asked, what must I do to inherit eternal life? What is written in the law, he replied. How do you read it? He answered, love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your strength and with all your mind, and love your neighbor as yourself. You have answered correctly, Jesus replied. Do this and you will live. But he wanted to justify himself, so he asked Jesus, and who is my neighbor? In reply, Jesus said, "A man was going down from Jerusalem to Jericho, where he was attacked by robbers. They stripped him of his clothes, beat him, and went away, leaving him half dead. A priest happened to be going down the same road, and when he saw the man, he passed by on the other side. So too, a Levite who had come to the place and saw him passed by on the other side. But a Samaritan, as he traveled, came where the man was, and when he saw him, he took pity on him. He went to him and bandaged his wounds, pouring on oil and wine. Then he put the man on his own donkey, brought him to an inn, and took care of him. The next day he took out 2 denarii and gave them to the innkeeper. 'Look after him,' he said, 'and when I return, I will reimburse you for any extra expense you may have.' Which of these 3 do you think was a neighbor to the man who fell into the hands of robbers?" The expert in the law replied, "The one who had mercy on him." Jesus told him, "Go and do likewise." The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. Amen.
We hope you've been enjoying the broadcast so far. I am so excited that you have joined us today. Walk in the light, this beautiful light. Shine both day and night. Jesus, you are the light of the world. We thank our lay leader, Yvonne Jackson, for being a part of this online experience today with us. Well, we know that we at Buttonwood, we're doing some new and different things. And we just thank God for what he is doing as we're growing in God and growing in at our church, at our local assembly. Listen, we are online on YouTube. We're online on Instagram, and we're online right here on Facebook Live. You can join us every Sunday morning at 9 a.m. right here on our Facebook page. We are in the middle of a great series called Road Trip. And on this week, we're going to be dealing with this subject, I need help. Oh my God, have you ever needed help before? Have you ever been in a situation where your tire caught a flat, where you ran out of gas, where you needed something in your house done, but you needed help, but no one would help you? People walked right by you. People seen that you needed help, but yet no one stopped to give you any particular help. Well, here we are, find this good Samaritan who comes up against the man who had been robbed, the Jew that who had been robbed. And he's sitting on the roadside, and even a preacher walks by him. Oh, that a preacher right there. How many preachers do you know that have known that you've been in need, but yet they didn't help? Oh, they didn't even lift a finger to help you. Well, it seems like the likely people that would help you are normally the people that don't help, but the unlikely choices are normally the ones that go to help you. Well, let's talk about this Good Samaritan real quick. You heard the scripture in your reading, but we find out that this Good Samaritan in Luke, it accounts that the lawyer begins to ask Jesus, what must we do to inherit eternal life? But Jesus asked him the question. He said, lawyer, to summarize himself, what is written in the law? And the lawyer returns with the great commandment, love the Lord thy God and love your neighbor as yourself. Jesus replies that this is indeed the key of life. So I've come to let you know today that if you're not loving your neighbor as yourself, you're not doing the totality of the scripture. No one would beat up their own self. No one would neglect their own self purposefully.
No one would not help themselves when they seen their own self in need. So if the Bible is telling us to treat others as ourselves, if you would not neglect yourself, why should I neglect others? The lawyer then asked Jesus a follow-up question. Who is my neighbor? Jesus responds by telling the story, which has been called the parable of the Good Samaritan. This story is so compelling that it permeates into a popular knowledge far beyond the Christian circle. People who never picked up a Bible will recognize that the meaning of the term Good Samaritan is as someone who takes care of a stranger that is in need. Given the cultural ideas of a Good Samaritan as someone with extraordinary talent for compassion, we might be tempted to overlook the Samaritan that in Jesus' story, and yet it is important to understand our understanding to examine what Jesus describes as a successful businessman. The Samaritan in Jesus' story, upon the Jews' injury by the robber along the well-known road, the Samaritan likely traveled that road many times. The Samaritan likely was known by individuals there because when he went to the inn, he got a credit from the inn to actually stay there. He said, "I'll be back." So he was a well-known businessman. He was a well-known individual in the area. The innkeeper, he demanded that extension to services, and the innkeeper gave him the credit. Whatever the nature of the businessman, the Samaritan was successful enough to be able to afford all that he needed, the oil, the wine, for the medical purpose, and the lodging at the inn for the stranger. He is willing to spend his money on the stranger. He is willing to spend his time on the stranger. The Samaritan puts all his business to the side to see the needs of the injured stranger. When is the last time that you put your knees to the side to make sure someone was taken care of? The parable of the Good Samaritan can be interpreted as a story about using our material success to benefit others. The hero of the parable of this story, he spends his money on a stranger without a direct obligation. They are not related by kinship in any way, or even by faith. Yet the Samaritan spends his money on this individual. Samaritans and Jews were often agnostics toward another. Yet in Jesus' mind, to love someone is anyone who needs help that becomes your neighbor. See, it's not based upon what you look like, what social class you have, what you have in your bank, what religion you are, whether you're Methodist, Pentecostal, Baptist. Loving your neighbor simply means that helping someone that needs to be helped is helping someone that needs to be helped. As I close this message, I want you to know that the Samaritan doesn't just help the injured man by throwing a few coins at him and sending him on his way. Rather, he makes sure that all his needs are cared for, both his medical needs and his need for a space to recuperate. The Samaritan thus cared for the man as he might care for his own self. This fulfills, he risks being saddled by the expense and the emotion or weight of caring for someone who has become chronically ill, but he takes on this risk because he acts as if it's his own life. It's Jesus' best example of how to love your neighbor as yourself. On today, I want to ask you a question. When is the last time that you have loved your neighbor as yourself? When is the last time that you have done someone something for someone that is a complete stranger? When is the last time that you have said, listen, I'm going to deny myself to help someone else? See, being a good Samaritan means that sometimes I have to do something that goes beyond the scope of my norm. Sometimes I got to go beyond what I feel as though is politically correct. I got to go beyond my denomination. I got to go beyond my race. I got to go beyond my social, economical circle. And on today, my question to you is, if I need help, are you the Good Samaritan? So Father, we thank you for this opportunity to just share in your word, I need help. Thank you because even as we have had the opportunity to share, that individuals are out there that said, hey, I need to know the Lord. Well, this is your chance. Today, in three parts, one, I want to pray for you. And I just want you to know that if you never heard this word like this before, now is the time for you to have prayer. You can put it right in the chat right now. Pastor, pray for me. Send your email address to us. Go on our website, send your email address to us. We will pray for you. Number two, if you want salvation, we're here. And we have our prayer warrior standing by that can help you receive the Lord Jesus Christ as your Savior. Lastly, if you are not a member of a church, listen, we want you to be a part of this great body called Buttonwood Fellowship, Buttonwood United Methodist Church. This great fellowship. We want you to be a part of us. All you have to do is just email us. And guess what? You could be a part. You don't even have to come and be a part of our in person. You could be our online member, our online member. So why don't you be a part of our Buttonwood family? So Father, we thank you today for those that have gathered. We pray for those that have listened to this and said, hey, I want to love the Lord thy God with all my heart and I want to love my neighbor. Well, those that have said that today, Father, I pray that they would have a change of heart, change of mind, that their actions may show that they want to love someone else, Father, and that they will help that stranger that's in need on this week coming up, Father. We thank you for all that you are doing, have done, and going to do in their lives. Father, bless them supernaturally in a way that you have never done before. And it's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. I am so excited on today. Thank you for joining us for another broadcast right here on Buttonwoods UMC Online.